Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Duo here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to What If Episode 3. What if the world lost its mightiest heroes? Now, this is apparently the one set during Fury's big week, back in Phase 1, so I expect that we'll revisit several of those movies. What was that? Iron Man 2, Thor, I think the Hulk as well. So, yeah, we'll probably see at least those three. Maybe we'll see Captain America and Black Widow or Hawkeye in this as well. Well, Black Widow was in Iron Man 2, so, yeah. The synopsis is, Nick Fury struggles to launch the Avengers when candidates are targeted by a serial killer. Okay, so there seems to be someone hunting down specifically Avengers. Don't know who that could be. I'm assuming we're going to find out this episode. Now, I'm also assuming this is the one where we got Loki in front of the UN and had the Asgard army up against S.H.I.E.L.D., so could that be because Thor got killed, or, who knows? Well, we will after this episode. Anyway, let's get it started in 3, 2, 1, go. Never going to skip the intro. I don't know if there's a setting or not to turn off that feature. But there's no need for me to watch the intro. I just want to. Okay, so the first episode of this was okay. The second episode was great. I have a feeling this one's going to be somewhere in between. Jeffrey Wright, The Watcher. Samuel L. Jackson, Nick Fury. Jeremy Renner, Hawkeye. Mark Ruffalo, The Hulk. Tom Hiddleston, Loki. Clark Gregg, Phil Coulson. Jamie Alexander, Frank Grillo. Lake Bell. Mick Wingert. I don't know who those ones are. One's probably going to be the one taking over for Black Widow. One's probably going to be the one taking over for Tony. I mean, so it's a theory that all of this is set in one reality, so are we really seeing vast realities? A vastly different reality, yes, but Monday. This would be Iron Man 2. Yeah. We saw that we'd be revisiting this in the trailer. I mean, that's fair enough. Yeah, I don't think that was lithium dioxide. Demon in the Bottle. The Hulk. And Thor, yeah. Yeah, the main universe. Yeah, that's already out the window. Hey, it's Rumler. Is it? I wonder if that was the same person who voices Rumlow in the MCU. I think a few of these expected the punches. Yeah. Yeah, your whole team got taken out by one person. Again. Why do I have a feeling that Hawkeye's hand slips? And that's how Thor gets taken out. Because he did have the shot lined up. I mean, really? Yep. Hmm. That's true. Would have thought he'd smell like ozone. Coulson, being weird. True. I wonder if that's the same Betty Ross from okay. True. Get down. Rightio then. Bifrost. Yeah. That's a fair assumption. Yeah, I know you're Odin's elite, but I don't know how you'll go up against guns. Oh yeah, this is the gas canisters. If it's any consolation, the agent who killed him is dead. It's so weird seeing Ruffalo Hulk in the Hulk, like, set pieces. You know, it's probably a good thing they had their cars this time. Maybe not. No, not really into the whole inflation thing. That's, Is that Jamie? I don't know if it is. Very nice, okay. So is it? I have a feeling there'd be no Abomination in this timeline, because he never got the second dose, because he didn't get absolutely demolished by I didn't see who that last one was. What is she? Hope Van Dyne? So, is that Janet or Hank? Are you going to page her? Yes, he is. Okay, we're not getting Danvers. He's going to see Mephisto, everyone. It is the Destroyer. That is all its name is. San Francisco. That's a yellow jacket suit. I mean, he's not wrong. Yeah, I don't think you're beating Nick in a fight. What did he get from... That's Loki. He's the only shapeshifter I can think of. That took me longer than it should have to realize what was going on. Indefinitely. Yeah, because I can't actually pick up the hammer. Why is there a book on Hawkeye's one? Fair enough then. That is not the direction I thought that episode was going. I was right in all of my assumptions at the start of this video. So that's big props for me. Didn't guess about the whole Yellow Jacket thing, but I don't think there's any way I could have. Probably should have been able to from the whole nanotech thing, because no one had... I wanted to check the voices. Jeffrey Wright for The Watcher, Samuel L. Jackson for Nick Fury, Michael Douglas for Hank Pym, Lake Bell as Natasha Romanoff, yep, Mick Wingert as Tony Stark, Frank Grillo was Brock Grunlow, Stephanie Panicello as Betty Ross, I don't know if that's, who normally voices, well, who did voice her. Mike McGill was General Ross. Alexandra Daniels as Captain Marvel. Huh. Interesting. I'm gonna go see what those three, maybe four voices are from, and if I know them. Okay, so Natasha, Tony, Betty Ross, General Ross, and Carol were all different voices. Lake Bell, I know from watching a couple Poison Ivy from the new Harley Quinn show. But I'm pretty sure I'd know her voice from if I scrolled down on her IMDb page more. Mike Wingert, he voices Iron Man in a lot of animated things. Mike McGill does not have many acting credits. Stephanie Panicello, I have not seen her acting before, but she does a lot of video games. And Alexandra Daniels is also got very little acting credits, so yeah, I only know two of them. But yes, that was a very interesting episode. I was surprised to find out that at the end of it, Loki ended up taking over Earth. Considering, well, it was under a lot of people's assumptions that his actions during Avengers was because he was mind controlled by the scepter, which we know to be true. However, it seems as though he's jumped at the opportunity, like, I can easily overpower these people, plus I've just helped save the world. Might as well decide to rule. They've got no defenders, I've got an entire army and several gods. Not much they can do to stop me. Plus, it means I don't have to go back to terrorizing my father on Asgard. Not really much to say about the episode. Like I said, it went mostly how I thought it would. But yeah, I guess that's about it. So far we've had a mediocre episode, a great episode, and one that's in between those two. So who knows what the quality of the next episodes are going to be. I'll catch you in the next one.